Ladies and gentlemen, this is a one-fall match for the National Heavyweight Championship. Introducing first in the corner to my left, the administrative director of Tully Blanchard Enterprises, James J. Dillon. Ladies and gentlemen, introducing the challenger from San Antonio, Texas, in at 236 pounds, Tully Blanchard. Ladies and gentlemen, this is the National Heavyweight Champion, a 10-year veteran of the NFL, the greatest Indian wrestler of all time from Oklahoma, 260 pounds, Rahul McDaniel. The referee, Randy Anderson.
For the National Heavyweight Championship, then, Tully Blanchard, a former champion, trying to regain that championship from Chief Rahul McDaniel. And you heard that introduction, and I have to agree with that, Johnny, the greatest Indian wrestler of all time.
Hey, bar none on that one. The legend himself, Chief Rahul McDaniel, said, don't go away, because, you know, this last week, a belt changed hands right here. Dusty Rhodes became the world television champion.
That's right, and we may have another one doing just the same thing. Wahoo! Reversing that on Blanchard as he comes off of the rope for the hip toss. And remember this, Johnny, when you're talking about a belt changing hands, it very easily could. Tully Blanchard, who held a world's television championship longer than any other individual, and not only that, also having that national championship, has held a number of championships.
And now that the national championship, losing it recently in the Los Angeles Forum to Wahoo McDaniels, and they are back at it right here again. James J. Dillon complaining to referee Randy Anderson for something.
Well, the referee has started to count each time. Tully gets a foot across the ropes, trying to get Wahoo to break that wrist lock. Wahoo drags him back to the ring. Now Tully goes out.
James J. Dillon outside there trying to give his man every edge that he can, every little bit of advantage that he could possibly inflict into the match for his man.
Dillon's so mad he's about to blow a gasket out there. Boy, is he irate. Now the referee having a real discussion with Blanchard. They're not talking about what you're going to eat after the match either, Johnny. They were upset with each other.
Many men that have went up against Wahoo McDaniels have become irate before the match is over, and most of them have went down to defeat.
Here's the chief now, back to the corner by Blanchard.
Very cautious. Oh,
boy, he blocked that right and retaliated with the right hand. He saw that one coming. He knew Blanchard was going to try to do something when he had him back to that corner, and Wahoo blocked that right hand.
They're trying to slug it out, but you don't slug it out with the chief, because sooner or later, those chops will take their toll.
Tommy Hawk chopped to the top of the head. Nobody chops like Wahoo. A mistake on Blanchard's part, standing toe-to-toe, trying to chop with Chief Wahoo McDaniel.
Tremendous chop. Cut him almost in two, and Tully Blanchard is very lucky he rolled to the outside of the ring after that one.
The referee into the ring now, starting to count. Blanchard down on his back out of the ring. Here is James J. Dillon talking to the referee. They're going to get Wahoo back across the ring. He's going to start the count all over again. Johnny, as you said, very fortunate he managed to get out of the ring. Actually, he was thrown out, rolled right under the rope. Otherwise, he could have been counted out right there.
And Blanchard, a little rubber-legged right now. He's going to take, trying to get the belt in there. Randy Anderson right on the job. Wahoo McDaniel, a good chop. Dropped Sully down to the mat. Missed that one. Tully escaped. Lateral press. Just two. Blanchard had the instincts of being a champion for so long, was able to get that shoulder off the mat just before the free count hit the mat.
Dillon got hold of a foot and just pulled him toward the rope.
Well, an extra edge, an extra little bit of advantage. Anything that James J. Dillon could do. And the opening part of this match has left Blanchard leaving a little worse for the looking of the two.
Blanchard now seems to have his head a little clearer at the moment as he's going to be pushed back to the rope. He's under the rope again. Now he's going to be shoved again out of the ring.
He'll try and slug it out again.
Again, he's going to try to stand toe-to-toe with the Chief. Boy, Dillon needs to talk to him.
Dillon needs him on the outside. A lateral press again by the Chief.
Again, a count of two, and again, now Tully got a foot on the ropes.
That's awareness of a man that's been champion most of his wrestling career, and he knew where he was at. Even though he's taken a beating, he knew exactly where he was in that ring, and that foot was able to save him from a free count. Now Dillon will get to confer with him.
And you better believe right now, see, you can see that Dillon is saying, hey, don't stand there, don't stand toe-to-toe with him and slug it out. That's the mistake that you've been making.
Blanchard also catching a little rest here. And now he's on that back bicycle. He's backpedaling.
Again, trying to get a little breather here is Tully Blanchard down on a knee in the corner. Johnny, I wouldn't be surprised now if we don't see Tully fight the rest of this match in a different manner after Dillon had talked to him outside the ring.
And double leg dive. Feet on the rope. Caught by the referee, Randy Anderson.
Chopped again by Wahoo. He couldn't go down. The ropes were holding him up. Now he's down from the chop.
Lateral press again. Blanchard this time gets that foot again. He was aware of where he was in the ring. That's what made him a champion, kept him a champion for so long. Aware of where you are at all times, even though you're taking a tremendous beating as he is from Wahoo. Now to the leg. And it's Blanchard with the upper hand. Back and forth. These great athletes go.
Blanchard got a foot into the knee, went to the knee into the ropes. Fans, NWA Pro Wrestling, the major leagues, and you're seeing two of the greatest right here, Wahoo McDaniel, Tully Blanchard.
And Blanchard again trying for that leg, a single leg takedown. Wahoo tying him up as best he can. You know, Blanchard, one of the four horsemen, Bob. Many times on wrestlers like Dusty Rhodes or Rock and Roll Express, they went for that knee. They went for the leg. We've seen him hit him with a chair on that leg. And again, it's Tully Blanchard now taking that leg of Wahoo McDaniels, and he will slowly and methodically start wearing that leg down.
Talking about the four horsemen earlier, Johnny, I know you heard the American Dream, Dusty Rhodes, say that it's time to really put the hurt on the horsemen, and he named Tully Blanchard, Arn Anderson, Ole Anderson, and also won the Nature Boy, Ric Flair. And fans, right now, let's watch the action in the ring as the match will continue. We're going to take a break, and we'll be right back with more action after this.
We'll be right back after these commercial messages about the NWA Pro Wrestling event coming to your area.
Fans, a heated battle in the ring continues. Here's Tully Blanchard outside now. He must have got a cramp or something in that leg. Johnny Weaver, as we saw, J.J. Dillon there rubbing down that muscle in that leg of Blanchard. He continued to be punished by Wahoo McDaniel.
Well, Bob, you know, Tully Blanchard was working on the leg of Wahoo as the four horsemen have another different opponents. Wahoo turned the tables. He'd been giving him back a little of his own medicine. He was really clamping down on Tully Blanchard's leg. We'll see how Tully feels after this. Whoa, he missed a roundhouse left uppercut. He thought he had Wahoo suckered up, but Wahoo did not come in, and Tully missed it.
Boy, he was ready for him when he swung that left hand. Wahoo just holding his ground, but that one right there. Oh, now here's the Chief out of the ring. He's going to chase him around the ring. Tully Blanchard said the safest place is back in the ring with Wahoo outside.
I think the Chief is really fired up. Tully had been outside of a lot of this match. He went out again, and the Chief decided just to follow him out there. And let's see what happens on the floor.
Dillon coming up behind. Wahoo distracted him, and that gave Tully Blanchard just the opening he needed. There's the post. Wahoo slammed hard to the post.
Trying to cut it with his shoulder, Bob. And that may be a break for him. It could have been a lot worse, but Tully will take advantage of that.
Down on the concrete floor of the arena, Wahoo slow now to get to his feet. Wahoo McDaniel now calling on his reserve strength and stamina as he's back up on the apron of the ring. And now Tully Blanchard,
when he's got the upper hand, that's when he is at his very, very best.
Forearm by Blanchard.
A lateral press now by Blanchard. There's two and a cheap escape.
Almost a count of three. I thought we were going to have another championship change right here. The referee had his hand up ready for the third count before Wahoo got that shoulder up. What a tremendous condition that these athletes have to be in, Johnny, to take the punishment and the pounding and to give out the punishment that they've done so far during this match and continue to go.
Well, J.J. Dillon outside now seemed like he was a lot more confident and he's going to get a belt back. Well, Wahoo comes out of the hole. Tremendous jab again, and down goes Blanchard, but Wahoo misses a chop on the mat. And back and forth, these two great athletes battle each other.
Well, look at Blanchard with those elbow drops.
And one, and two, three times. Be a title change.
Oh! Almost! Close! Again, it comes from, as you say, Johnny, knowing where you are at all times and what's happening. And Wahoo just did get that foot on the rope.
And he's got it there again. Tully pulls it off. Wahoo's got them both over there. Referee Randy Anderson going to have to make him break. There's the feet of Wahoo on the rope. Good shot, guys. And up here is Blanchard continuing the attack. Trying to wear Chief down. He knows he's got him in trouble. Body slam by Blanchard.
High for the knee drop, and he missed it. The Chief rolled right out from under it just in the nick of time. Another tremendous tomahawk chop. They both go down.
Right, both men down like two freight trains. They really hit both men at top speed. Collided his. Dillon trying to get Tully up. Wahoo trying to get up.
Wahoo first on his feet. Blanchard walks in the corner toward him, and Wahoo just grabs him by the hair. The war dance and the tomahawk chop.
Lateral press by the Chief. Dillon up on the apron.
Wahoo over to bring Dillon in the ring.
What's he going to do? Pile drive him.
Blanchard with a pile driver now. And Wahoo McDaniel's going to roll him over, cover him, and he's going to be counted out.
Holy cow. That pile driver, the referee must not have seen it. The referee must not have seen it. Oh, he's going to give him the belt.
Decision. Dillon in the ring. Here's the American Dream, Dusty Rhodes.
Bedlam has broken loose, Bob. Mayhem. Bedlam. Everybody's out of the ring. Well, Dillon and Blanchard seem to be leaving. Wahoo's still the champion. After being laid out by that pile driver, referee Tommy Young reported to referee Randy Anderson about the pile driver. They reversed the decision, and the belt does not change hands.
Back to Chief Wahoo McDaniel, still the national champion, and what a finish, fans. And you saw Dusty Rhodes in to clean out the ring. and to really protect Wahoo. Watch again this ending in slow motion, Johnny.
Here's where Blanchard gained the advantage as Wahoo had his hands full with James J. Dillon. The referee over there with Dillon does not see this maneuver. The referee does not see this pile driver, which is illegal. And there is Blanchard giving the pile driver to Wahoo. He did get a three count, but the decision was reversed. There you're going to see the three count. The decision was reversed. Wahoo McDaniels remains the champion.
All right, and fans, we'll be back. We'll talk with Jim Cornette.
Slow motion replay of what was happening, and here the referee over. That was where he had reversed and changed that decision, Johnny.
And here you see Blanchard and Dillon attacking Wahoo. They went for a chair, which they had done with the American Dream Dusty Rhodes, the Four Horsemen had. But there's the Dream.
That's right. The Dream into the ring just in the nick of time as Tully had a chair up for Wahoo.
And the Dream cleans house, and he's got the chair. At that point, they really screwed us, Dillon and Blanchard. They get out of the ring, and Wahoo to McDaniels remains the champion.
And fans, we'll be back. We'll talk with Jim Cornette and the Midnight Express right after we take this brief timeout.